Databases support various data types to store date and time information. The most commonly used ones are date to save a date without time information, time to store a time without a date, and timestamp to store date and time information. You can map all of them with JPA and Hibernate, but you need to decide to which Java type you want to map your database column. Java supports quite a bunch of them. JPA supports most of them. In addition to that, Hibernate provides proprietary support for almost all of the remaining ones. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen, and I solve Java persistence problems for a living. I will show you how to define the different mappings in this video. We will start with the mapping of the classes in the Java util package, then we take a look at the mapping of the Java SQL classes, and we end the video with the mapping of the classes in the Java time package. But before we start, if you're new here and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring, and all types of other Java persistence related stuff, subscribe and click the bell icon to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful. By doing so, you are helping me to reach more people with it. Before the release of Java 8, Java Util Date and Java Util Calendar were the most commonly used classes to represent dates with and without time information. You can of course map both of them with JPA and Hibernate, but the mapping requires a few additional information. You need to define if you want to map the Java Util Date or Java Util Calendar to a column of type date, time, or timestamp. You can do that by annotating the entity attribute with temporal and provide a temporal type enum value as a value. You can choose between temporal type date to map it to a SQL date column, temporal type time to map it to a SQL time column, and temporal type timestamp to map it to a SQL timestamp column. Let's check them in the IDE. I'm using the temporal annotation in this code snippet to map an attribute of type Java util date to a timestamp column and an attribute of type Java util calendar to a date column. You can then use these attributes in the same way you use any other entity attributes. If you activate the logging of SQA statements, you can find the following messages in your log file. The second message about the binding of the Gregorian calendar might surprise you. That's Hibernate's very complicated way to show you which calendar object gets bound to a parameter of type date. But don't worry, if you take a look at the database, you can see that Hibernate wrote the date to a column of type date. The mappings of the Java SQL classes date, time, and timestamp are easier than the previously shown mappings of the Java util classes. That's because the classes in the Java SQL package match the SQL data types. That enables your persistence provider, for example Hibernate, to identify the mapping automatically. So without providing any additional annotations, these are Java SQL date gets mapped to SQL date, Java SQL time gets mapped to SQL time, and Java SQL timestamp gets mapped to SQL timestamp. You can then use these attributes in your business code to store date and time information in your database. And after you activated the logging of SQA statements, you can see that Hibernate maps the entity attributes to the corresponding SQL types. Java 8 introduced the date and time API to fix the flaws of the Java util date class. Using the new API is clean and concise, and you can finally distinguish between date and time information. Since Hibernate 5 and JPA 2.2, you can use all the classes listed on this slide as attribute types. As you can see, Hibernate supports a few more date and time classes than JPA. You can easily add support for additional classes by implementing an attribute converter. I used it in a previous article to map an attribute of type duration with JPA. Hibernate's proprietary support for duration and instant works fine. But you should be careful if you want to use Hibernate's mapping of zone datetime. The handling of time zones and the mapping to a timestamp column presents a few pitfalls. I will get into more details about that in the Working with Zone Datetime video, which you will find in the description. Let's first take a look at a basic entity mapping. As you can see, these mappings don't require any annotations. The classes of the date and time API clearly define if they store date and or time information. So the JPA specification and all implementing frameworks can map them to the corresponding SQL types. As I mentioned earlier, using Hibernate support for zoned daytime is risky. Let's be honest, I don't recommend using it. Hibernate maps a zoned daytime to an SQL timestamp without time zone information. It converts the zoned daytime into the local time zone of the JVM and then stores it in the database. And when it reads the timestamp, it adds the local time zone information to it. Hibernate shows the time zone information in the log message, but you can see in the database that it converted the time zone from UTC-4 to UTC+2, which is my local time zone. This mapping works as long as you use a time zone without daylight saving time, all instances of your application use the same time zone, and you never have to change this time zone. You can avoid these problems by configuring a time zone without daylight saving time in your persistence.xml configuration. Hibernate will then use the configured time zone instead of the one used by your local JVM. I recommend using the UTC time zone. When you now rerun the test, you will not see any difference in the log file. But if you look at the database table, you can see that Hibernate now converted the zone daytime to the UTC time zone. JPA and Hibernate can map database columns of type date, time, and timestamp to various Java classes. You can map them to Java util date and Java util calendar, Java SQL date, Java SQL time, and Java SQL timestamp, Java time local date, local daytime, offset time, offset daytime, zone daytime, duration. You just need to decide which Java type you want to use in your code. I recommend using the classes in the java.time package. They are part of the date and time API, which was introduced in Java 8. These classes are a lot easier to use in your mapping and your business code. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video, and an ebook about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye.